This is a review of the ASUS G51JX-A1 notebook. This notebook recently came out, end of January 2010. This notebook ships with an array of bundled accessories such as this backpack, a Razer mouse, which matches the finish of the notebook, cable tie, recovery media, driver's disk. This is a backpack branded by ASUS but manufactured by Targus. Very nice backpack. There's many revisions of the G51JX in the market, but this one, the G51JX-A1, is the highest priced out of all of them. It does include all the accessories and ASUS Global 2-year standard warranty with 1-year accidental coverage and 2-way paid shipping. On the front of the notebook, we have a card reader on the bottom left, a wireless toggle switch here, LED indication lights here for battery, charging, hard drive. On the right side of the notebook, we have your audio ports, mic, out, in, out, SPDIF or headphones, USB 2.0 port, USB 2.0, optical drive goes here. The standard model comes with DVD-RW, but that can be upgraded to a Blu-ray reader or burner. On the back side, we have your lock port. Battery is here. Standard 6L is flush. The 9L sticks out 1 inch. AC jack, network adapter here. On the left side of the notebook, we have a VGA port, exhaust, a dummy antenna jack, which serves no purpose, a mini firewire, an eSATA port, which doubles as a USB port, and an HDMI port, and 2 more USB ports. Also, this has an express card here, which can house your SD card or as just a filler. On the side of the notebook, we also have on the screen lights which turn on during gaming. They can be controlled somewhat. This also lights up, and as well as the ASUS logo here. This is the same design as its two predecessors. The only thing that changed from the last version is the video card, the amount of RAM, and also, this only accommodates for 1 hard drive. The prior versions could have housed 2 hard drives. This notebook also comes with a backlit chiclet keyboard. This notebook comes with 2 speakers branded by the Alltech Lansing sound system, a 15.6-inch display with a resolution of 1920 by 1080 LED display. That is the highest definition you will get on this size display. Some of these notebooks will ship with a lower definition display depending on where you will buy them. Only the G51JX-A1 has this display. Always be sure to check the display resolution, hard drive size, CPU, warranty, even the bundled accessories, because depending on where they ship from, ASUS will bundle different specs. On the top of the screen, we have a 2.0 megapixel camera. The 5 buttons you see there, on the left side you have ASUS Splendid Technology, which adjusts the saturation and color saturation of the image. It can switch from vivid to standard to movie mode. The button in the middle is power for gear for conserving battery life. The middle one is your touchpad disable button. This button there, that's your express gate launch button, and here is your power button. The F keys you see there control everything from wireless to sleep functions to keyboard brightness to LCD brightness, external display, sound. The camera armrest is made out of a rubberized type of material. Feels somewhat pleasant to the palm. Kind of like your Lenovo ThinkPad exterior. This is how it looks in the dark or low light condition. And you can find the full specs of this laptop using the link on the right hand side of this video. That is what the 9-cell battery looks like. It sticks out roughly an inch. But this is 3D Mark running at full resolution, 1920x1080. The view angles are pretty decent, from left to right. Actually very good. No washing out of colors or anything. They get pretty bad when you turn the display up or down. This is 3D Mark running at full resolution. The left and right view angles are very good. The top and bottom are not so good. That's to be expected with most screens nowadays. After a good warm-up, the palm rests remain relatively cool. The exhaust vent, and right around there, starts to approach around 100 Fahrenheit. Probably won't get much hotter. The plastic itself, right above it, is around 110 Fahrenheit. At native resolution, 1920x1080, 3D Mark scores this just shy of 8,000 points. At 1600x1024 resolution, 3D Mark scores it at just over 8,700 points. This is the 3D Mark Vantage testing phase. Should have a score in a few minutes. . 3D Mark Vantage gives it the following scores: an overall score of 54, 47, and these subscores. Now the computer is running PC Mark Vantage. This test should be finished in roughly an hour. PC Mark Vantage gives it the following scores: roughly 5,600 points is the overall average. HDTune gives this notebook hard drive the following scores. This notebook weighs in at 7 pounds and 7 ounces with the battery in it, which is a little bit on the bulky side for a notebook this size. With a few windows open, wireless on, Bluetooth disabled, at 95%, this notebook is rated at 2 hours and 52 minutes. However, this is the 9-cell battery, not the standard 6-cell. The 6-cell would get a maximum of 2 hours, right around there. Under the hood, we have here a primary hard drive. This used to be the place where a secondary hard drive would go, but they replaced it with 2 DIMM slots. Here's 2 more memory banks. CPU, single cooling fan for both the CPU and GPU. This is the GPU, the NVIDIA 360. The wireless card is here. This can be upgraded with slight modification to an Intel 5300 wireless card. This is now an Intel 1000 wireless card. There are 3 antennas here